recording right now?
Yeah. I'm gonna edit.
Should I do one of those? Like at the in the news?
Wait, I didn't get that.
I just ran over Xander.
I'm John Estefano, and
I'm Glenn.
I'm Xander.
And we're Fun King 3D.
Alright, tell us your story.
We're a father and son team who does 3D printing and electronic projects. It's been more and more 3D printing and less electronic projects lately, but our goal is to not only learn, but then to reteach what we learn and establish a way for parents and kids, whether it's a father and son, a mother and son, a mother and daughter, a father and daughter, to interact with each other in the world of making. Yeah, Xander and I, him growing up as a wee little lad, we had a good relationship building the house to the point where like he actually helped me pull all the wire for the house. And then as he grew a little older, he decided he hated what he calls working stores, which would be, you know, Home Depot and Lowe's. And so all of a sudden he was all about the video games and I was still in the making, and 3D printing finally gave us something that we had in common. Okay, it wasn't really the 3D printing, it's the YouTube channel that did it all. So, but it is nice to have something to have in common.
All right, very good. Thanks, guys.
Yeah, absolutely.
I'm knitting, and I'm trying to do something like with corporate knitting.
Oh, very cool.
But yours is much cooler. I don't like my design now. Aww. Once I've seen yours. Are you filming this?
No.
All right, I'm here with Dave Shore. He's got some awesome stuff he's going to talk about.
Hello. So one of the things that I've been doing is I've been working on embedding materials into 3D prints via the means of printing for a little while, pausing the print, and then putting in either fabric or, in this case, metal rings. So I can create things like a movable mesh where the actual skin structure is actually very strong. So the thing that I am working on is getting to a point where things like having the rings or having the fabric becomes an automated process, so that we are actually making full products at the end, not just the parts of products. So, okay. So these are dragon scales, and the thing that I can do with this is I can get the exact placement of all the scales in there that I couldn't do by hand because I don't have the dexterity required to do this. But since I have the 3D printer, I can get that placement exactly where I want to the first time.
So we've seen a lot of things in 3D printing, but I got to say that this is one of the most remarkable things I've seen, because we're now taking cosplay to the next level. And he's even done it, you don't have it here, do you, with the LEDs?
No.
He's even done it now where he has areas that are hollowed out to allow placement of a specific size LED to light it up. So it's a really cool stuff. You're right on the cutting edge, David. And I think you're enabling, your concept is open, right?
Yeah.
Your concept is open, so which means that if you're not familiar with open concept, this is allowing others to do awesome work, but it could be considered more awesomer, is that a word?
Yeah.
Because they get to build upon it. There's things that David may not have thought of himself that other people are now going to use that as an opportunity to create the next level thing. So this is really awesome for cosplay people. All right, thanks for watching you do it, and thank you, David,
thank you
for helping out. What up, brother? How do you see your efforts helping others? Have you noticed anybody?
Yeah, that's actually why I wanted to become a maker, so it's all in at home. Hi, my name is Becky Button, and I've been a maker ever since I saw my first 3D printer when I was in the fourth grade. Now, 7 years later, I'm still making. What inspired me to become a maker was the ability for the technology to significantly impact the lives of others, especially in the scope of assistive technology. So relating this back to your second part of your question, how have I seen making my my projects impact the lives of others. One of the best examples I have of this is I did a hackathon where I met a woman with COPD, and the condition caused for every time she changed incline to change the rate of oxygen going to her oxygen mask from her what was called a portable oxygen concentrator. So I made a device that made it so that she could manipulate the buttons remotely, and this significantly improved the quality of life for her. She was able to go about things without getting so inebriated from manipulating the machine, because every time she had to, she went and changed the incline, she would have to taking it off. The process of taking off the machine from her back actually caused her to become winded. So that's why I wanted to become a maker, and that's how making has impacted the lives of someone else.
So this is John, when you do it. Thanks for watching, and thank you, Becky.
Yay!
This is John, when you do it, and we have Chris with Venturi 3D.
Hey, so basically this is our new printer that we're bringing to Kickstarter probably on July 10th. Basically, it is a fully enclosed, multi-material, multicolor. It has four spools of filament, so it can do four colors or four materials. It's designed to be very consumer-friendly. So basically what we're doing with this is we are pre-slicing over 1,000 models that are going to be pre-installed. We're using the best slicing programs to do that, such as Cura, Slicer, or Slick3R, Idea Maker. And then when the consumer sees this, they will have a touchscreen. They can view the model, choose what filament color or filaments they want to use, press print, and then it does the rest. This is also open source, so you can use any other filaments, any other slicers you want. However, if you do use our partner slicing, partner filaments, we have a QR code on the front. You use the camera right here, scan the QR code, and then it updates the color, temperature, and any other settings, and then it updates the G-code on the fly, because we use the SQL database in order to do all of that. So basically, we are going to be kickstarting this for early bird of $9.99, and the regular retail price will be about $12.99. And you can find out more information at venturi3d.com. We're also on Twitter at venturi3d, Instagram, and YouTube at venturi3d.